Hey, I'm Doug, the electrical service manager here at Penguin Air.
I'm Louie, I'm the plumbing manager here at Penguin Air.
We're going to review some electrical fill videos. Sit back and enjoy.
Hey guys, electrician videos here today. I just want to show you how we hook up a GFCI. As you can see, we got the load side already connected. We wait for the line side because we want to make sure that the circuit's off. Always check with your trusty tweeter.
We call those things death sticks.
We've had for 10 years and shorten these wires up a little bit.
What happened?
So he cut the hot wire and the neutral wire at the same time, which will trip the circuit breaker and cause a little explosion.
You know what? One time I was cutting through a wall, sawzall, and I found out that I hit a wire because all the lights went out.
Yeah.
That's cool.
Cutting 115 kV line.
The CGI is terrible.
So that's actually what happens when you cut a utility line and there's a load on the circuit. It will keep trying to continue that load until the wires are far enough apart.
There's not a safer way to do this?
You could probably turn it off.
wouldn't you?
Yeah.
What?
It's
Did you just see what happened? That's true? That's not fake?
No, that's real. Yeah. Like, that really happens when you cut the utility line.
I hope this guy makes a lot of money, because that's...
They make a ton of money.
Just to cut that?
Absolutely.
And then
absolutely.
What?
Well, they're probably doing some type of repair on the line.
Live like that? Like, isn't that a little dangerous?
It's really dangerous, yeah. That's
like,
why
I get
they have
sweaty
all these
palms. Like, I'm going to grab these wires with wet hands.
And they're probably, 20, 30 feet in the air.
Nice.
But yeah, that's what happens.
Cool.
It's the dangers of being a lineman. All right, Lou, so I've actually seen this video that we're going to watch next before. It is absolutely amazing. And this is a perfect example of why you should not do your own electrical work.
Okay, like me.
Like me.
It was at this moment that he knew that this was done.
What? Get out of here. What'd he do? What was he cutting? Why?
So he's actually trying to cut a line that's like hanging down from, like, that's actually connected to a fixture. And it's live. And there, it's probably 277 volts by the amount of sparkage and smoke that that thing kicks off. So,
but there's like customers around, these guys are eating, it looks like. Like, does he still have eyebrows after that? That's the question.
Yeah, I think he's gonna be okay.
The smoke.
Yeah, you see all the smoke? That is hilarious.
Wow. But the question is, why are the lights still on?
That's a good question, Louis. That's a good question. It's probably on a different circuit. Who knows what that circuit's tied to?
That is amazing.
Yeah. That's why you should always hire a licensed professional.
Yeah.
Like the ones here at Penguin Air.
No.
Oh, that is... That is some... DIY special stuff.
Whoa,
there.
What the heck?
It's just an accident waiting to happen.
Did they strap that to the roof?
They did.
Oh.
They did, yeah. That's another very dangerous thing. It's going to cause leaking.
Right.
The proper way to do that is obviously to support it with pressure-treated wood. And you typically don't want to run conduit on top of a roof either.
Oh, no. Oh, I
lied. Wow.
So that's a transformer, right?
Yeah, that's a transformer on a utility line. Two things that don't mix, electricity and water.
Wow.
Being a fireman, he should have known that. You definitely want to let electrical fires burn out. Or use a fire extinguisher, something with some type of powder inside of it. Never water. So if you see an electrical fire, what do? Don't use water.
Hello, Mr. George. How much you pay for the new guy?
Oh my goodness.
So what's up with this?
Well, it's open is the thing. So panels are outdoor rated, which means they can get rained on. You never should, but you can spray them with your hose and stuff like that, and they're going to be fine. When a panel is actually open like this, it's deadly dangerous. Like, you could essentially all that water that's coming down will become energized and will actually shock you if you touch it.
No way.
Yeah.
But let me ask you something. How come that one's got wires sticking out?
Well, like I said, this panel is open. And it looks like they're working on it. and it's right underneath a rain gutter. So you never want to work on electricity in the rain.
You know what? Mine at my house, now that you say this, the lock doesn't work.
Uh-huh.
So it just flies open.
Yeah, it's not good. You should definitely put some type of locking mechanism on there.
Like tape.
Not tape. You always want to be able to lock your electrical panel.
Like, well, flex seal it?
With an actual lock. Not only for safety reasons, but for criminal reasons as well. What we get a lot of times in the summer is that people will come through and turn off your AC breakers. And then they'll come back a couple days later. If the breaker's still off, they know that you haven't been home, and you're probably not going to be home for some time. And then they'll break in. And just a little lock on your panel will deter the average criminal from breaking in using that method.
That's good to know. You know when the song comes out, right?
Actually a pretty small little electrical discharge there, but he probably grounded himself out. He's very confused about what's going on there.
You know it's bad when you just stare at it.
Yeah.
Or you just stare at it.
Well, Apple, thanks to you, today's the day I become an electrician. Or die.
Oh my goodness.
That can't be real. Yeah. That can't be real.
Yeah.
No way. Dude, is he alive? Is there like a part two to this? Like, what?
Right? They end it pretty quickly. So that looked like a broken charger inside of a wall socket. So electrical...
Never charging my phone again.
Yeah. So if that happens, you're going to want to go out to your electrical panel, turn off the breakers, and then pull it out.
If you're still alive, it looks like.
Yeah. That was a big explosion.
That's crazy.
His breakers were probably pretty old and needed some type of replacement.
Hello, boss. Yeah, Michael. I have a problem.
All right, you got to break that one down for me.
Okay, so this is a bunch of cut cable coax, it looks like. It's some type of, data center or something like that. It looks like they were cutting something and... sawed through all those wires, which, a lot of times they use this for, security cameras, TVs, internet, stuff like that.
That looks intentional.
There's actually no live voltage going through there, but it's still alarming to see all those wires cut.
But what was he trying to do?
Yeah, I'm not too sure why they would cut those out.
I have a problem. It looks like you created a problem. What? Your grinder works? Yeah.
Well, he's very lucky that those weren't live wires. There's no current that actually goes through those TV coaxes, So you can pretty much cut them without dying. Not like the other ones we've seen where you cut them and it explodes.
Like this one here.
Yeah.
This one here. So right before it starts,
we can see a burnt GFI.
You know you're scared when you're holding something.
Yeah.
Like, you know what I mean? Like, what is he? Okay, this
is client says outlet not working.
What do you think's gonna happen?
I think it's going to spark and explode.
Okay, it looks like it already did.
It did.
So we're just gonna go ahead and just
Right. That would be my assumption is that it's going to explode.
Did I
hear,
Bob?
Receptacle not working.
Oh, boy.
This guy is brave.
That's dangerous.
See how he cut that hot wire out right away?
Can you explain why you think that's going on?
No, there's probably a short inside there somewhere, and the breaker's not even tripping.
Oh, boy.
Something's going on, but it's not even reading anything.
It's dead.
So that actually did trip the breaker. You have GFIs in your home, right?
Mm-hmm.
So GFIs, like, they go bad. I've probably replaced a few hundred GFIs in my time for this reason. Like, they will go bad internally and essentially catch fire. So it is super scary they do that.
How do you prevent that?
you want to stay current on your electrical breakers. Probably, I would say, 15 to 20 years. You want to make sure that you have your breakers replaced. GFIs every 10 to 15 years. Staying current on your electrical system is probably one of the most important things you can do to prevent, you know, stuff like this from happening. But this was obviously an electrician. He was very careful not to shock himself and disconnect the power from the GFI.
Bare hands.
Scary stuff, yeah. Thank you guys for watching the Penguin Pro Show. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tune in next week to hear from Louie, our plumbing service manager, while we review some plumbing fail videos. Thank you.
Woo!